still do it? Yes. Because if this money, his money is involved, then it's called Hajj Badal. If his money is not involved, in lifetime or after, one way or the other. Like son wants to do Hajj for his father, or a daughter wants to do Hajj for her father or her mother, anybody, or uncle, auntie, anybody you want, as long as they are Muslims. As long as they are believers, you can do on their behalf. This Hajj will call Tatawwu. Yes? Tatawwu'an. Ek tamattu hai, that Hajj tamattu, that's Hajj category. This is Tatawwu. Ta, ta, waw, and ayn. Tatawwu'an. That means optional. You're doing something extra from yourself. Yes, nafal, which is not a compulsory upon you, not obligatory upon you to do it. You're doing to be kind to them and do on their behalf. So you can do it. That can be done as well. You understand that? So that is the logic. This is the information we have from the Quran and Hadith. That it says that we're supposed to, and we can do on behalf of somebody else. No. One thing is something is compulsory, and you have to do yourself. You can't make anybody else your assistant. But if it's optional, you can do for each other. Nobody can say, I can't say that to you, do some nafal for me, do 100 nafal for me. You understand that? Because this is going to be duty bound. I'm asking you, I'm demanding from you. But you can do and give that reward to me. I can do and give that reward to you. Why? Because Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that when you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship Him, and at that time you pray for your parents as well. You understand that? So ulama and Rasul, from the both meanings are there, with two ways of understanding of the meaning. One is that when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you make dua for them. If they passed away. I'll make sure that keep our ears and eyes there, sir. That's another one. Sorry, would you be pushing out to get Allah if I was for my Asapi, Uri, Armun, it's Minana. Never give the Rumi Chonana, the Rada Kula, okay, was with someone in the Randa. The Mamma was to be in the Gauder. I make sure that everything is safe. Allah would taste a bit the pushing of Adminum, Kurbat Gumani is Mamma Racho, okay, Memo Judo, some of the most safest person is there. The Kurban, she would need Mala Sanasi. So, you can't demand, you cannot demand from anybody that you do work for me, but you can do on their behalf. So from that hadith I told you that Rasulullah SAW said that if you pray for to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of your own, you pray for your parents as well. What it mean? It means that you make dua for them, or what you do extra nafil on their behalf. And ask Allah, Ya Allah, this is worship I did to you. If whatever you reward me, the reward is transfer this reward to in the account of my parents. Or anybody else you want to attend for. You understand that? You can do that. So in that base, I just thought maybe that some other guys are there, maybe they're thinking, I'm just giving all this from my own mind. There is a book called Jawal Haq, Farigat Mehmet Judhvi. Is it? No. Ahmad Yal Khan, sir. As his book, this person was Deobandi first. First, all Deobandi was listening to him. But later on, after distribute as well, he defended them, then lately came out of the Deobandi Jamaat and into Jamaat Ahle Sunnah. And he, it's called Intisab, connected this book with PC Jamaat Ahle Sunnah. Who was the Nath Intisab? In there he wrote a special chapter on this bab which we are discussing on first of all Fatiha. So know what we can do. We can also do nafis, we can do hajj, and also we can spend the money on behalf of someone. Okay, we already understood that because wealthy, you can be assistant of somebody. So Rasulullah has been encouraged, do the sadaqah for the people they are passed away from you. Do the sadaqah on their behalf. You understand that? So if you do, there's lots of hadiths are there which proves that sadaqah is illegal. Like in the Babu Sadaqah, very well known hadith of Sa'd radiallahu anhu, that he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, my mother passed away. And she didn't have much of wealth on her, so she hasn't done much of sadaqah. Can I do sadaqah on her behalf? So, yes, you can. So what shall I do, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Sir, whatever is best you can afford. So he said, Yasula, I want you to select something for me. At that time, there was a well. One quote says there was a well, and it was in the possession of the Yahudi. The other quote is that Rasulullah Mutargani said that there is a well. You Muslims are in the shortage of water, so you can dig the well for them, spend some money. So you have to hire the people to dig that. So get the water for the people. One way or the other, he dig the well and got the water, or he bought off the Yahudi. Because it's very, very expensive. So when it was come in possession of the Muslim, he came to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the well is there, either is my possession. Oh, I have digged it, it's ready to drink the water, I want you to come and bless it. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came and he made dua. So this is another day, they have this, lots of itradat people they have as well. In fact, on Katila, it will take hours and hours and hours. But bring some out for you as well. He made dua. Say, Ya Allah, hada li Umma Saad. This is for the Umma Saad, Saad's mother. So he explained then short word that this is on the name of Umma Saad. So as Rasulullah also said as well, that as long as this well is in use, drink in water, make an ablution, have an ghusl, use it for any purpose that Muslims needs is there, your mom will get that reward. You know, who done the work? Saad radiyallahu anhu. Who got the reward? Saad got the reward. Saad is not the missing one. And his mother as well. You understand that? So that's whatever you do, you won't be missing. You're going to get as well, so as other people, whoever you're going to attend for. You understand that? So like this, there are a number of hadiths. No. This itra some de Wahhabi, de Bandi, they do as well. Or you have khana samne rakh lete ho, to ye dua karna. Samne kyun rakhte ho? Why you put in front of them? This is the hadith we put in to them. That when well was there, did they put behind them? Or was it in front of them? So it was in front of them. That's what they said. Here is the, that's Haza li Umma Saad. Haza is Ishara, Ismi Ishara, that this is for Umma Saad. You understand that? Then also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the Qurbani day, sacrificial day, on Eid day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to, Bismillah. Sabhiya kiya kitam.
Thik is
that? Adhiya kiya kitam. Aagi tam. Hum to andre baithe hain, isliye unhe jilaya bhi hai te, usse fayda uthana chahiye. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has asked Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu kareem to bring two lamps and describe them as well. They should be black with a white spotted nice beautiful one. When they were bolted down, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi look at them, seen them, he touched them, that he likes it. You know, he showed that when you like something, you like to touch that as well. So this is all the activity he has performed. Then he hand over to Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu kareem. So he asked, Ya Rasulullah, why the two? So one from Muhammadin, one is from Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and min Ali Muhammad. Ek to Al ki taraf kiya hai, one ko Ali said hai. Al means descendant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You understand that? So Al bhi agar ho, to dusre to hai na, somebody is doing it on behalf of someone. You understand that? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doing on behalf of his descendants, his children, his lineage. One. The other hadith said that, there are both hadiths are correct. Hadha min ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is from the ummat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You understand that? So, when it's from Ummat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that means Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did the action, he bought the land, and Ummat will get the reward. So it's Salih Ashab is this, but that means you can earn and transfer the reward to someone else. Same question replies again, why are you putting the things in front of you? We said, here is a hadith as well. When the boss lamb was in the front, one was for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one is for Ummat of Rasulullah. So, what did you say? This is Ummat. It's not the same, it's not the same, it's not the same, it's not the same. याद इसका कैसे कोई आदमी इसलिए कह सकता है पीछे वो सामने रख के करते हैं सो दैट्स व्हाट इट इज सो व्हेन यू डू समथिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू लाइक ऑफर समथिंग इफ यू ऑफर समथिंग व्हाट डू यू लाइक दिस डू यू समबडी ऑफर यू लाइक दिस वुड यू लाइक इट और सम टाइम मे बी यू आर इन द फ्रेंडशिप दैट यू आर बोथ स्टैंडिंग टुगेदर और मे बी यू आर अ कॉपी योर एग्जाम वर्क एंड जस्ट हैंड ओवर बिहाइंड इज इट एनीबडी कैन डू दैट वन डू बट दैट्स अ चीट और लाई ये इसको बेईमानी कह सकते शराफत में तो कहीं नहीं आता. When you do something openly, nicely, properly, you do in the front. And here's for you. Whatever you give. You understand that? So we're doing legal thing in Islam. We're not thefting. So that's why we put all the things that which we're offering. Why? Because we are offering that. You understand that? Then they say, oh, you know what, a khana.